Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Pharmacy Iconer. Today's topics of discussion is the energy losses. It is under the flow of fluids. Now, what are the energy losses? In the Bernoulli theorem, we have deducted the frictional forces from the left side equation. Now, if a fluid is flowing through a pipe, it will face different resistances for which there will be the loss of the energy. This loss of energy is called the energy losses. So, energy losses are the four types. Number one, friction losses. Number two, losses in fittings. Losses in fittings. Number three, enlargement losses. Enlargement losses. Number four, contraction losses. So these are the four energy losses. Now we will discuss one by one. First one is the friction losses. You know, when the fluid is flowing through a pipe, there will be energy loss due to the friction. This is called the friction losses. So, the fluid flow in the pipe may be the viscous or turbulent, or sometimes the transitional flow. When it is the viscous and turbulent flow, we can determine the energy losses by the fanning equation. Fanning equation. Fanning equation. So in case of viscous and turbulent flow. LENT, viscous or the turbulent flow, and the pipe is the straight pipe, then we will use the fanning equation. Here for the frictional losses, there will be the pressure drop. The pressure drop is the delta P, and due to the friction, pressure drop due to the friction is equal to 2F U square L rho divided by the D. This is the fanning equation. Now, this is the delta PF is the pressure drop. F is the friction factor. U is the velocity of the liquid, meter per second. L is the length of the pipe. Length of the pipe, it is the meter. Rho is the density of the fluid. It will be the kg per meter cube. D is the d is the diameter, diameter of the pipe, diameter of the pipe. So Fanning equation used in case of the turbulent flow and also viscous flow. Here pressure drop directly proportional to F, U, L and rho, inversely proportional to the diameter of the pipe. Now if the flow is the viscous flow, then we can use the Hagen-Poiles equation. Then it is the Hagen-Poiles equation. But normally it is impossible to give the flow of viscous flow. For viscous flow we will use Hagen-Poiles equation. In case of the viscous flow, so here delta P F is equal to 32 L U eta divided by this square. This is the Hagen-Poiles equation. Delta PF is the pressure drop, L is the length of the pipe, U is the velocity and eta is the viscosity of the liquid, D is the diameter of the pipe. Now we will discuss about the loss in fittings. You know, for a long pipeline there are so many fittings in the pipeline. This will cause the disturbance of the flow of fluids. For this reason there will be loss of the energy. This is called the loss in fitting. Now, loss in fitting may be due to the types of fitting and the direction of the flow. Suppose a pipe fitting contains the elbow, it may contain the T, fittings, it may contain the coupling, so due to these fittings there is a loss of energy. This is called the losses of energy in fittings. Normally in conventional method we use the equivalent length of the straight line pipe. Next is the enlargement losses. When the cross section area of a pipe is gradually, you see, enlargement increases gradually, when the cross section of area increases gradually there will be no loss of the head or no loss of the energy. Suppose this is U1 and U2. Now if the
there will be the sudden enlargement of the cross section area like that. So then there will be the loss of energy or loss of the head. Here is the U1, velocity is the U2. Now water will flow or fluid will flow in this manner. There will be a eddies formation like that. There will be formation of the eddies at the corner. For due to the eddies, there will be the loss of the energy. Now, here, no doubtly, U1 is greater than U2. U1 is greater than U2. Then, head loss will be delta head loss of enlargement HE is equal to U1 minus U2 whole square divided by 2G. This is the heat loss or energy loss due to the enlargement. And why there will be loss? Due to the formation of the eddies. And last is the contraction losses. It is the just opposite of that. Suppose the large pipe, a large cross section area, if there is gradual decreases the cross section area, so there will be no loss because the fluid will adjust itself, accommodate itself, so there will be the no loss. But if there is a sudden contraction like that, there will be the loss of energy, that is called the contraction losses. So fluid flow like this way, in this manner, the lowest cross section area of the fluid flow, this portion, this is that, it is not the lowest at the opening, it will be some apart from this the opening. This point is called the vena contracta. This is the smallest cross section area of the fluid flow. Now it is the U1, it is the U2 velocity. Here U2 will be greater than the U1, no doubtly U2 will be more than the U1. Now in this case, we can neglect the E1 because here the velocity is minimal, velocity is least. So we can neglect it. So what will be? This will be like that, U2 square. You can neglect it. So it will be the U2 square. E2 square, and for that we have to give a constant k. So for heat loss due to the contraction delta hc, it will be k E2 square divided by 2g. So this is all about for the energy losses. Thank you for watching this video. थैंक यू।